Let's talk about when pornography hits our home or when other addictions related to technology hit our home, because that's very related to counseling. Yeah. But how do we step into it, that first step, right into the moment where you find out or you begin to discover, I think we have an addiction in our home and we need to respond to this?
Well, and it's huge today because screen time has never been higher. Screen ownership has never been higher. 79% of teenagers bring their device into their bedroom every night. And that's where a lot of it is viewed.
Sad,
right there.
Isn't it? Yeah,
so it is very common. And that's sort of go back to what you've probably heard me say in other conversations. Again, our reaction really matters. And that's where sometimes we tend to almost come across with, and I hate to say it, but in a way it's kind of shaming. What I know some of the overreactions I had, I'm like, it kind of shamed them a little bit.
Our because we're reactions, panicked, right?
How
we're
can, panicked. How yeah. would you watch that? Filled yeah. in my, I didn't raise you like that, right? You know,
yeah.
and because it's a, it hurts us. I didn't raise you like that, you know?
That's
so how'd you
scary,
have that filled
yeah.
in this
yeah.
home? You know,
yeah.
I got that
I feel a little nervous.
Yeah,
right
exactly.
Yeah.
And that's where we need to have that practiced response.
Right.
That's why I always tell parents, man, honestly, your kids are going to mess up. It might be pornography. It might be sneaking a phone. It might be even something smaller or bigger. I don't even know.
Yeah.
But when they mess up, I say, it is so good to be able at that moment, be able to hit the pause button and convey your unconditional love for them. Because at the moment they're thinking, uh-oh, does mommy or daddy mm-hmm. not love me anymore? You know, especially at the younger ages. And mm-hmm. if you could just say, hey, guess what? I don't even know what to say. Just give me this device real quick. Okay, cool. Or unplug it from the wall or whatever you have to do. And then say, I need to go pray, but I just want you to know something. I've messed up countless times and there's nothing you can do that mess up that would make me stop loving you. I just need to go pray because I don't want to say something stupid because I love you so much. So let's talk about this tomorrow. I love you. And can you imagine?
Mm.
Think of the times that, you know, we probably all have memories of our parents laying into us over something or other. And sometimes we need it. But can you imagine if we just received this giant, hold on, I love you. We're going to deal with this
yeah.
later.
I got to read,
you know?
I have to read for a little
and
while.
And that's the best
right.
advice. Cause
right.
when you see that, to try to deal with that right then in the moment, sometimes it takes praying. It takes thinking about it. It takes this. And our first response isn't always our best response.
Right. Right. Just remember as a parent that this is a journey and there are going to be a lot of imperfect moments. Don't go to, I'm a bad parent. That's mm-hmm. that's the wrong place to go. This is about having to now step in. There's a war for your child's soul. And you get to step into that and have the opportunity to bring life back into something that has been taken, where life has been taken within your child. And so step in, but as you said, be patient with it, take your time, because it's a very important conversation. Gain some wisdom, call our counseling line, 1-800-A-FAMILY. You can speak with one of the counselors
here. Such a good resource.
To kind of really start to regroup, do it together as spouses, as you go into the conversation with your child to show the unity around that and to begin to pray for your child specifically and then put check-ins in. Many times we'll go into these conversations, it's 1 week of full blitz and we're fixing this, we're resolving it. There are a lot of commitments made and no check-ins after that.
Yeah,
this is the beginning
for
of
three
a new
years.
Thing, right? Yeah. It's the beginning of a new thing, maybe weekly and then monthly, and it's a rebuilding of something very important in your home. Pornography creates some dynamics inside your child, and you're going to help them learn about what that means and then how to begin to respond to what is happening inside their body as they understand it more.
And that might look like discipleship. I always tell dads, like I wrote this guy's guide to four battles every young man must face. And the thing is, I tell dads all the time, I said, I put discussion questions at the end of each chapter for one reason. So you get with your son for breakfast once a week. So it's not just a one-time thing, but it's an ongoing thing where you're connecting with your kid. And you know what? He probably isn't gonna remember a lot of the lessons, but he's gonna remember dad hung out with me and we always ordered those really cool pancakes at Denny's or, you know, some other fine dining establishment.
So it's great as a dad to step in, have those conversations, be intentional as you talk about a variety of things around technology and entertainment. As moms and dads, you have unique roles and unique contribution with your kids. This is not about making your kids happy. This is really about guiding and teaching them, and you're going to get a wide range of emotions along the way. Mm-hmm. I hope this has been a benefit. Jonathan, thanks for joining me.
Oh, thanks for having me.
And having
fun
this
to have
question
a conversation.
And answer time. Yeah, so Thank you. May God guide you along the way. We believe in you. You've got this. As parents, remember that. Make sure you pray each day for God's wisdom and strengthening in your spirit as you create life in your home. Thank you.